New Life Evangelistic Center simply wants to do the work of God and help the hurting and homeless. But it seems like the attack from the enemy has no limits. We're going to take a look at that during this program. I'm going to share with you a new lawsuit they're filing just to keep us from opening a day center. I'm talking about neighbors filing against New Life Evangelistic Center in the city of St. Louis to stop the city from giving us the necessary permits. Be sure you stay tuned. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. I'd like to believe the best. I'd like to believe the innate goodness of mankind. But as a friend recently pointed out, in the last days, the love of many is going to grow cold and people are going to become increasingly wicked. Reminding me, have you read 2 Timothy, Larry, and see what they're going to be doing in those last days? I guess I should not be surprised then that some of the very wicked neighbors surrounding 1411 Locust would file a lawsuit against the city of St. Louis and New Life Evangelistic Center, trying to stop the city from giving New Life Evangelistic Center the necessary permits, as it has gone forth and spent hundreds of thousands of dollars doing each and everything the city wanted it to do so it could reopen 1411 Locust. New Life Evangelistic Center has removed the fire escape from behind the building. It's put in a sprinkler system. It's brought all the plumbing and the electrical up to date. It's putting fireproof doors in. Each and everything that's been asked. Now neighbors afraid, like Sanballat and Tobiah were when Nehemiah was about to get the walls finished. And if you're not familiar with the book of Nehemiah, the book of Esther, you may not be aware of what I'm speaking of, so you might want to go back and reread your Bible. But they vehemently fought them, just like today we're getting that. Instead of knives and swords and spears, they're using legal proceedings. Call it a legal lynching. But we're not giving up at the New Life Evangelistic Center. We're going to continue. There's too many lives at stake to do anything and everything we can according to the law to get that facility open back up. We already, in the event the city would drag its feet and fall into the hands and the pockets of rich folks that moved into the neighborhood that want to put the homeless out of sight and out of mind, after two homeless people have already died in downtown St. Louis, it seems like they care less about human life. They just don't want to see those people in the neighborhood. Talk about raunch bigotry, hostility. I mean, against the poorest of the poor. I thank God for those that are praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. I thank God for those demonstrators that are starting to recognize that this is an issue that needs to have a stand taken up, and they need to speak up and speak out at this time. And some are beginning to do that. But I ask you to please join us in earnest prayer at the New Life Evangelistic Center. We simply want to help the hurting and homeless. You know, we just want to get engaged in the service of the Lord like we were in that particular facility. Yes, our work is growing all over Mid-America. Great and mighty things are happening in Springfield. We're seeing so many people helped there on a daily basis through that fabulous day center that we have opened there. And we're seeing so many people being helped in the Overland area that come to us for energy assistance and other assistance. We're in the process of opening a free store over in Illinois and have additional sheltering in those locations. But we need your prayers right now at New Life Evangelistic Center, because we need to get our day center open at 1411 Locust Street. We're standing in the bitter cold along with the homeless, trying to distribute the bus tickets to them each week that they need, trying to distribute clothing to them, and it's freezing temperatures out there. We could have a free store they could come through and sort out and receive what they need. Please pray for us at New Life Evangelistic Center. And please get involved. Continue to share your much-needed gifts, which are making such a big difference. And that's at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. And maybe we should take it as a good sign that the city's going to be giving us our permits soon. And that's why, out of fear, which motivates so much of this, they felt they had to file a lawsuit against the city of St. Louis and New Life Evangelistic Center, as New Life follows all the different rules and all the different regulations, making all the different improvements, about ready to open. So I'm believing God that in the very near future, we're going to see so many people getting help like we've seen in the past at 1411 Locust. We're going to continue to just let God's light and love work through us as we open our doors back up, following all the different laws. And now here, the enemy has to sue the city because we're trying to follow the laws and they maybe give us the necessary permits. Well, we're believing God that those doors are going to be open in the very near future.
When I was laying on the sidewalk, did you step over our side, acting like you did not see me, not even caring if I died? Did you stop to dress my wounds or my nakedness to hide? Did you take notice of the nail prints or the piercing in my side? No, you just glared at me and curled your lips into a sneer. As my life's blood flowed out from my wounds, you didn't shed a tear. You couldn't stop to give me comfort, but not once did you draw near. I cried out to you for mercy, but you didn't even hear. My church would do you do to one another. Why do you close your doors and look away? Why don't you love the ones you should call brothers and help them in their growth from day to day? You say you must pay the rent and the utilities while you leave my children hungry in the cold. But haven't I been providing everything you need? So why haven't you taken them into your fold? It's a sick who have need of a physician. The righteous I did not call on to repent. So why are you so choosing to the ones I called on to me? Open your doors and let them in. They may not be dressed in the best of fashions, and ties they may not always have to give, but take them in with love and my compassion, and understand the reasons that I live. I said, go preach the gospel to all creation. Be sure that you share it with all men. This is my desire. Go take the world with fire, 'cause quickly I'll be coming back again. Now did I turn away a single one of you? Do I open up my arms to draw men? So why are you so choosing to the ones I called on to be? Open your doors and let them in, then let me in.
I want to thank God for all of you that continue to pray for the New Life Evangelistic Center. Yes, we're in the process of opening our doors at 1411 Locust. It won't be long now, folks. So many things have already been done. God is moving just such a great and mighty way. I thank God for the wonderful people that are donating, so we were able to remove an old fire escape the city wanted removed, that we were able to fix all the plumbing and the electrical, that we were able to put in the sprinkler system in the worship studio, and putting in the fire retardant walls and doors, and following just all the laws. And the enemy is angry. Satan walks around like a roaring lion seeking may devour. And angry enemies of the homeless continue to rise up and do anything and everything they can to try to stop the work of God, but it will not be stopped. You all are praying. You all are donating. God is moving in a mighty way. Yes, they just filed a lawsuit, not only against New Life Evangelistic Center, I'm talking about the neighbors. Not all the neighbors. This is just some here at 1426 Washington. The company there, they filed this lawsuit against us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center, and the Neighborhood Improvement Association of Downtown West filed a lawsuit against New Life Evangelistic Center and the city of St. Louis to try to stop the city of St. Louis from following the law. We're following the law. But you see, there's so much bigotry among some of those people in that downtown, that Neighborhood Improvement Association, Downtown West. They don't want those kind of people in the neighborhood. The word homeless has become the new N-word in America today. If they don't like down and outers, they just call them homeless. And they throw into that the whole name of homeless, of sex offenders, vagabonds, derelicts, drunkards, dope addicts. I mean, that's, and they forget about that poor woman with their children, the man that lost his job. Yes, the person that's struggling with mental illness out there. And yes, even those that do have habits that need help. And we're going to give them that help. As they come into the day center at the New Life Evangelistic Center, we get to know them. We get a chance to work with them. It's a Christian community doing the work of God. You know, it's people making a difference. And it gives people an opportunity to make a difference in someone's lives. We've done this over the years in the past. So many have gotten off the streets that are working for the Lord now in a mighty way, working in radio stations, television stations, and agricultural projects, renewable energy, working in other shelters and free stores. God is moving in a mighty way. When we get our day center open, we'll get our free store open back up. And the homeless will be able to freely get the clothes. They don't have to stand out in front of City Hall in 0-degree weather, 10-degree weather, shivering, trying to get bus tickets and trying to get clothes. I mean, we'll be able to offer them direct help. But wicked people don't want that to happen. Their bigotry runs so deep and it's so profound that they'd rather leave the people out on the streets to freeze, to suffer, to hurt. And what we're talking about right now, step one is opening up our day center at 1411 Locust. Such a fabulous day center open at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. So many homeless people getting help there. Yes, it's going before the Missouri Court of Appeals as far as the shelter operation is concerned. And that's in February. Now we're doing everything to get in during the day. Please pray for us. Pray that God will just grant immediate victory and squash this lawsuit from people that just don't want those people in the neighborhood. These are human beings. Their only crime is they've lost their home. It can happen to anybody. I'm asking you to please pray for us and pray for those that would file a lawsuit like this. Pray for their souls. You're familiar with the story of Lazarus and the rich man. Well, the rich man at least allowed Lazarus in the neighborhood. What happens to these people? Pray for their souls. And please continue to pray for us at the New Life Evangelistic Center. And your involvement with New Life Evangelistic Center is making such a big difference in the lives of people. So many people have been helped in the past. I'm believing we're going to get the doors open back up and they're going to be helped like that in the future. Only more people are going to be helped. Glory be to God for those of you who are praying, caring, and sharing. I just thank God for each one of you during this critical hour.
Are you making a difference in someone's life? Are you standing in the gap for love? Are you throwing out a lifeline to a hurting soul who needs your love? Are you making a difference in someone's life? Do you lay a substance on the line? Are you making a difference in someone's life? Are you willing to take the time? Pain is all around us, suffering everywhere. Hunger and oppression, hurting and despair. Do we stand and watch it with a hardened heart? Or are we overwhelmed and don't know where to start? Are you making a difference in someone's life? Are you standing in the gap for love? Are you throwing out a lifeline to a hurting soul who needs your love? Are you making a difference in someone's life? You lay a substance on the line. Are you making a difference in someone's life? Are you willing to take the time? Time is getting shorter for some out on the edge, and most of us at idle are just live inside our heads. Is your conscience bothered when you see so much lack? Or do you intervene to get them back on track? Are you making a difference in someone's life? Are you standing in the gap for love? making a difference in someone's life. Do you lay a substance on the line? Are you making a difference in someone's life? Are you willing to take the time? Someone's life. Do you lay a substance on the line? Are you making a difference in someone's life? Are you willing to take the time? Are you willing to take the time?
For 46 years, New Life Evangelistic Center is making a difference in someone's life. And this week, we are celebrating our 46th anniversary, 46 years of direct service of helping the poor and the needy. So many people have been set free from the cycle of homelessness as a result of you wonderful individuals that have been sharing with New Life Evangelistic Center, standing with us. And that's why I really want to encourage you to come out and join us this Saturday from 10:30 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. at the Royal Orleans Restaurant in South St. Louis. We're going to have all these different displays that are set up. And you can come, stay as long as you want, leave as soon as you want. But we want to encourage you to come on out and be a part. I want you to meet the staff. They're going to have all these displays setting up, representing all these different areas of outreach. Just such a tremendous opportunity for you to make a big difference in the good of someone's life by really getting involved. And I want to encourage you to do that. And for further information, directions, call us now at 421-3020. That's 421-3020. They're going to have a big 46th anniversary birthday cake there that we're going to be happy to share that with you. And they're going to have other food that's going to be there. But the great thing is going to be wonderful Christian fellowship. And toward at the end of the event, like about from 1 to 1:30, Vanessa Coleman and my son Chris and Martha are going to be leading in some songs. It's just going to be a great time of getting together and meeting the staff, like 20 different displays. I just really want to ask you to just please pray for us and plan to join us on that day at the New Life Evangelistic Center's 46th anniversary celebration, 46 years of service. Yes, you've heard a lot about the closing of the 1411 Locust Building. And yes, the enemies of the homeless will go to any extent to keep the homeless off the streets. We've had a lawsuit filed against New Life Evangelistic Center in the city of St. Louis because we're getting close to getting this building open back up again. We've spent many thousands of dollars doing all the stuff they wanted us to do. The enemies of the homeless are, and who are those enemies of the homeless? Well, in this case, this lawsuit has been filed by the Neighborhood Improvement Association Downtown West and 1426 Washington Avenue. They have hired Mr. Elkin Kistner, a man that doesn't hesitate to go out here and work for those that want to shut down and keep down the homeless and the hurting and the 1411 Locust Building. And I'm asking just please pray for us as we're fighting to get it open back up. And, we fight not against flesh and blood, but principalities, powers, and spiritual forces. I know the devil is mad because people were getting saved, delivered, got off the streets. They were coming into the training programs. Now what do they got? Well, the city will open up its bill house to additional services when it gets below 20 degrees. My friend, Grover Perry, he died when he was 37 in a porta potty, and others homeless have died. But so it's below 20, yeah, there'd be that. But then a few degrees above 20, wander the streets all night. And even when they do open up other places, there's no God involved. You go into that Biddle house that tells you no proselytizing here, and you talk to the homeless. No, the last thing on their mind, the people that are offering the service are Bible studies, sermons, Christian songs, all the stuff. We minister to the whole person at the New Life Evangelistic Center. We take it serious of following Jesus Christ. And yes, we have people that may not be Christians. We will help them. We just show them the love of Jesus. And this is what we're doing at 1411 Locust. And so, of course, no wonder the devil and the enemies of the homeless are mad, and they want to try to do everything they can and file lawsuits and try to stop every way they can. Didn't they try to stop Nehemiah? Read the book of Nehemiah. See how Sanballat and Tobiah tried to stop him when Ezra and Nehemiah building the walls and bringing back worship into the area. And that's when we're bringing back worship. And we just want to continue to glorify God because we want to follow what Christ said. And in front of 1411 Locust, there's the homeless Jesus. And he said that foxes have holes and birds have nests, but he, the Son of Man, had nowhere to lay his head. And he said, whatever we do to the least of these, the homeless, we've been doing to him. And he spoke about this on so many different occasions. So if we're serious about following Jesus, we need to do this work. We need to stand up against those principalities and powers. And I need you to stand with us at this particular time through your prayers. Please earnestly pray. And through your gifts to the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. And come on out this Saturday. Come on out. I want to meet you. And the staff want to meet you. And anytime between 10:30 and 1:30 at the Royal Orleans Restaurant in South St. Louis, I'll be looking forward to meeting you there, because together we're going to continue in following Christ. going to continue to pray for us at the New Life Evangelistic Center. The recent lawsuit that was filed in the circuit court for the city of St. Louis by a business at 1426 Washington down the block and the Neighborhood Improvement Association downtown west. The basis of the suit against the city of St. Louis and New Life Evangelistic Center is to stop the city of St. Louis from issuing the permits. The city of St. Louis, though, I know that New Life Evangelistic Center has been making the improvements. My contention with the city of all this time has been, why did you shut the place down to make the improvements? We could have continued to helping people, but that's a different issue. But now they're working with us and are approving our architectural plans and just approving each permit because we're spending the money, the contractor's doing the work, the job's being done. You all are donating. I thank God for you. And in the very near future, we're going to be opening up as a day center. As far as the overnight shelter, that's before the Missouri Court of Appeals. They should be hearing that in February. So keep that in your prayers also. And pray for people that would do this kind of stuff, that at all cost would try to, they're out of discrimination, hearts fill with bitterness and bigotry toward the hurting and the homeless. They've already shut down the day center that was over at Centenary Methodist. They've shut down the Horizon Club, all the different places helping the homeless. And I'm asking just pray for those individuals. You're familiar with the story of Lazarus and the rich man? And the rich man, he does give Lazarus the crumbs that fall from his table, and he ended up in hell, burning in hell. Lazarus goes to heaven, and you need to read that parable and see it and pray for these individuals because they won't even allow Lazarus in the neighborhood. They want to drive him out of the neighborhood. Not only won't we let them have their crumbs that fall from their table. So pray for those individuals. Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do or who they're messing with. Because Jesus said, as often you've done to the least of these, even so you've done unto me. And I thank God for all of you that have been showing your love for Christ and following Christ, that have been standing with us, that have been sharing your gifts with New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, at 63166. I really want to encourage you to come out Saturday and see all the things that your gifts are doing as we celebrate our 46th anniversary of the New Life Evangelistic Center. I mean, this is just so exciting what God is doing, and we're going to have all these different displays set up. You can come anytime between 10:30 and 1:30, and they're going to have the food there. They're going to have a lot of time of fellowship between 1 and 1:30. Vanessa Coleman's going to be singing along with my son Chris and Martha and his wife. And I just want to encourage you to come on out. I want you to meet the staff. I want you to see what the Lord is doing at this particular hour. And just let your light so shine before men and women, they may see your good works as you link up with New Life. And there's so many opportunities that you can get involved in there. You can go out on the streets with our teams that are on the streets. You can work in our different free stores. There's unlimited things. That's why I want you to come on out. And if you want directions, you want further information, don't hesitate to call. Call between like 8:30 and 4, 314-421-3020. That's 314-421-3020. And I just really want to say thank you to each one of you that are praying right now, each one of you that are giving right now. You are a blessing in the lives of so many people. And I'm just praying that Jesus will just bless you and bless you and bless you as you continue to support New Life Evangelistic Center. Like I said before, we've gotten the old fire escape down. We've put in the sprinkler system in the worship studio. We've got the plumbing electrical completed, putting fireproof doors and walls, and all this stuff's taking place. We're getting close to opening. And what is it? The enemies of the homeless now sue the city of St. Louis to try to stop them from issuing us the permits. And they're just following the laws because we've been following the laws. We've been doing what we got to do. So I'm asking you to just pray for those people out there that just are living in such fear and bigotry, where the new N-word to them is homeless. And let's have a beloved community. And let's believe God for miracles right now. God is just moving in a mighty, mighty way. And we're going to get that place open back up because of all of you that are praying, caring, and sharing. So I hope to see you this Saturday. God is just so good. So many souls are getting saved, but I believe there's many more that are going to be. The devil's mad, but greater is he who's in us than he that's in the world. Yes, Jesus is Lord.